Hi, my name's Tony Calamita. I am the co-founder and CEO of the Love Hemp Group. This morning, we announced our trading results for the recent financial year. And I'm going to go through a short presentation just to discuss that announcement and, you know, paint some color to the announcement today. So welcome to the Love Hemp Group trading update. And we have some of the key highlights from the announcement. Our sales are down to 3.6 million, which is 16% less than 4.3 million the prior year. And, you know, considering the challenging backdrop of COVID and the impacts of the geopolitical situation, and especially the impacts from the extensive delays to the publication of the novel food register, we feel it's a strong trading result, especially now that we move out of H2 with some really encouraging numbers that really show a positive sentiment and positive trajectory of where the business is now going following the operational review that happened earlier in the year. So our H2 sales are up by 11% to 1.9 million over H1 of 1.7. Our Q4 sales in comparison to the same previous quarter last year are up 15% to 0.97 million. And this has all been done while we have significantly cut costs during the H2 period as a result of the operational review. As well, our units sold are up to just under 234,000 units, which is 19% up from the prior year. And as a brand-led business, it's very purpose-driven to have more products going to consumers than ever and having a positive impact on their life. That's a very important thing for us as a company. Online new customer accounts are up 7,500, slower than what we would have wanted. And as a result, and as part of the operational review, we've appointed a new head of digital commerce to help drive those D2C sales. And really importantly, one of the biggest factors of this year is the successful inclusion of all of our products onto the novel food register. And already since that time, we've agreed two new major retail listings. So, you know, it's a real positive place for us as a business where we stand today. You know, we've reduced costs, we've increased revenue, we've got new additional listings coming in the following year, expected for September. And the operational review that we announced a few months ago has had a real transformational effect on the business. There's been significant changes throughout senior management and at the board. And the impact of those changes are already being seen now, which are demonstrated in the positive results shown in H2. So also in the announcement, there was some discussion around our brand equity and how we have positioned ourselves as a leading UK CBD brand. This is by independent surveys, by which one we've quoted that we did in November 2021 as part of an exercise to better understand the impact of the Anthony Joshua TV and media campaign. And what that survey showed us was that 19% of adults were aware of the Love Hemp brand, which was higher than any other CBD brand quoted. And interestingly, the words premium, quality, trustworthy, and natural were some of the words most highly affiliated when they were asked what brand, what words would you associate with Love Hemp as a brand. Additional to that, we've won multiple industry awards, which we have been doing year on year, and we did again last year. And, you know, brand has always been a big thing for us. The market with CBD is very saturated, and it's really important to have an identity and to stand out and be memorable. And, you know, the partnerships that we acquired with the UFC and Anthony Joshua last year, you know, they make a huge difference in building our identity, in giving us visibility, but most importantly, they give us credibility and validation. And all of this brand equity gives us a very unique proposition when we're working towards building new major retail listings. And the new retail listings that we have already agreed in the last few months since the novel food list was published on the 31st of March is testament to that. So moving into the new financial year, we are, you know, revenue is growing again, which is fantastic. We have the new major retail listings agreed. Our costs are down. The business is more efficient and resourceful with a positive move towards profitability. The major barrier that really affected us throughout the last year of not being on the novel food register due to the delays is now behind us. And we have all 34 ingestible products on the list. We have strongly positioned ourselves as a leading UK brand by both independent surveys and multiple industry awards. And that allows us to have significant advantages over our competitors in brand awareness, visibility, and credibility when competing for these very important new major retail listings, which are now opening up off the back of the publication of the Novel Foods Register. And to support all of this and to help grow revenue further and to help serve our customers better, we have an extensive NPD rollout strategy to develop industry-leading products. And we're really looking forward to getting these rolled out over Q3 and Q4. And from a global expansion perspective, we have that unique international opportunity with the UFC partnership. And so all of these things combined make for a really exciting time for the business. You know, cash is tight, but we are managing it exceptionally well. And, you know, one of the positives is that it's driving the business to be extremely resourceful. I also want to mention that we have started the search for our permanent CFO. And as soon as the right candidate has been located, that role is ready and waiting for them. And of course, this will bring more financial rigor and control to the business. And what more can I say? Times are good. Internally, the team is absolutely buzzing. There's a real excitement in the business for where we sit today and with the positive trajectory that we have aligned ourselves to have as we move into the next financial year. I'm really looking forward to continuing the success that we achieved in H2 as we move into this new year as well. Thank you very much.